Sinclair Wonder Bear. At the moment Emily fell asleep, Sinclair held Teddy Bear figured of how tight Squeezy cuddles. He put on his Wonder Bear costume and set off along the village to see if anyone needed his help. He had to work fast. He only had until the morning when Emily woke up to help. As many people as he could. He didn't have long to wait. Help, help! The train tracks are broken and the train is coming. Sinclair dived down to next to a very worried guard who was jumping up and down. "Quick, Sinclair, I need your help. Can you fix the tracks before the train arrives?" asked the guard. Sinclair could already see the train roaring toward them. "I can't fix that. I can't fix the tracks that quickly, but I'll make sure the train doesn't come off the rails," said Sinclair, and he flew to the tracks and lay down. "Bear of steel," he said, and immediately he turned into a bear made of very tough steel, and just in time too. The train rattled it over him, but Sinclair was now made of strong metal and didn't feel a thing. "Oh, thank you," said the guard when the train had gone past. "You saved everyone on that train, Sinclair Wonder Bear," he said, said Sinclair. Quick as a flash, he changed from a bear of steel into Sinclair Wonder Bear again, and off he flew on his way around the world. "Oh, help! Someone please help!" It wasn't long before Sinclair heard someone else shouting.
"Go."
Sinclair dived down to see what the problem was. "Oh, Sinclair, thank heavens you've come," said Madame Jolly, pointing to outside her flat. A lorry had broken down her and her front door was completely blocked. "Lucille, my dog is injured and it's time for her walk," said Madame Julie. "What shall I do? What shall I do?"
"Don't worry, Madame Jolly, I'll handle this," said Sinclair. He leapt in front of the lorry, yelling, "Bear of magnet!" And immediately he became a magnetic bear. Sinclair was such a strong magnet. The lorry started to move towards him at once. And as Sinclair walked backwards, the lorry rolled forwards until it was safely away from Madame Jolie's front door.
"Sinclair Wonder Bear," said Sinclair, changing back from a magnet.
"Oh, thank you," smiled Madame Julie, kissing Sinclair. "You are a star. You're welcome," said Sinclair, and off he flew to see if anyone else needed his help. Far below him, he could see a big man with a mustache and a tiny woman with a floppy sun hat arguing with Captain Bass. Sinclair dived down.
"You said we'd be able to see lots of fish and coral reef from your boat," argued the man. "Mr. and
Mr. and Mrs. Pinchel, you'll be able to see them if you look over the side or go swimming in the sea, Captain Bass tried to explain.
I want to see them from inside the boat, not outside, right? Said Mrs. Pinchel. But that's impossible, Captain Bass began. Mr. Lee. I am able to help, said Sinclair.
Come with me and I'll show you how, said Sinclair, giving Captain Bass the thumbs up. Sinclair led the way onto the boat.
Quicker than quick,
Sinclair removed a few of the wooden planks at the bottom of the boat. Then he lay down to replace the planks he just removed. Bit of glass, he said. It was amazing. Sinclair was now as see-through as water. Captain Bear's sail vines. Mr. and Mrs. Pinchel stayed inside the boat. Thanks to Sinclair, they could see the fish and the coral reef beneath them without having to get so much as a tunnel vet.
Help! Sinclair, quick! We need your help, Captain Bass suddenly called out. Sinclair replaced the planks faster than fast, and everyone rushed to the side of the boat to see what was wrong.
A boy's just fallen into the water, Captain Bass pointed to another boat somewhere away from them. Jack can't swim, shouted the woman from the other boat.
I rescue him, said Sinclair.
How? Asked Captain Bass. You're still made of glass.
Oops, said Sinclair, looking at himself. In all the excitement, he'd forgotten to change back. Sinclair Wonder Bear, he said quickly.
We've got the plan, but I need you to hold up to my arm, and whatever happened, you mustn't let go. What are you going to do? Asked Captain Bass.
Watch Bear of Rubber,
and right before the rise, Sinclair turned into a rubber bear.
He stretched. Right out until he could wrap his underarm around the boy, gagging and splashing in the water. But the sea spray was making Sinclair very slippery. Captain Bass couldn't hold on to him. Twang! Sinclair was shot into the sea. It's okay, Jack. I've got you, Sinclair told the boy. You've got me, spurted Jack, but who's got you?
I'm working on it, said Sinclair, thinking fast.
Quickly, Sinclair changed into a round life belt. Jack slipped the belt over his head and put his arm through so that he could stay afloat. Captain Basil leaned closer, and Mr. and Mrs. Pinchel used a rope to pull Jack and Sinclair out of the water.
I'm freezing, said Jack as he sat on the deck, dripping with with his teeth chattering like castanets.
I'll help you, said Sinclair,
be a fool.
And instantly, Sinclair was made of warm, dry, fluffy fun. He wrapped himself around Jack whilst Captain Bass and the other boat headed back to shore. I'm feeling a bit better now. Thanks to you, Sinclair, smiled Jack. I'm glad, said Sinclair, but now I'd better get home before Emily picks up Sinclair Wonder Bear. Sinclair shot up into the sky and headed for home. What a busy few hours he'd had. He flew into Emily's open window and snuggled down beside her. He didn't want to wake her up. Emily's bear, Sinclair whispered, and immediately she turned back into Emily's very own teddy bear. Want a great big yawn. Goodness me, I'm tired. And with that, Sinclair fell fast asleep. And I'm not surprised, are you? The end. Hello everyone. Hope you like my video channel. Please don't forget to subscribe.